Hello, welcome to KBTV. This video is about a KB article, how to renew an ONTAP self-signed SSL certificate by command line. This video shows you the procedure to renew an SSL self-signed certificate on the command line in ONTAP 9 storage system. Policy, antivirus, and system manager or other connection to port 443. The HTTPS port may fail if the required certificate expires. In ONTAP 9.10.1 and later, use system manager to renew expiring certificate. We have a KB article about that. The name of that KB article is How to Renew an ONTAP Self-Signed Certificate in System Manager User Interface. Note, if there are any concerns about disruption of HTTPS services, perform this task during a maintenance window. Basically, that means, you know, if you renew your SSL certificate, would cause a HTTP server disruption. The first thing we should do is take a look at the certificate what we have on this server. Show builds vServer common name serial CA type expiration and type server. Okay, as you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 here, and this one is going to expire soon. The last one. In January 25th. Okay, so first we need to create a new one. Security, certificate, create, then common name, which is this, and then type, server, and size, 2048, and then email address. You can use yours, and then expiry days, let's say put a year, and then protocol SSL, and then hash function, let's say we use SHA 256, and the vServer name, SVM 2+1. Okay, it says we create a new one. Then we could show that. We take a look at this. So you see we have two here, and this one, the expiration date is December 16th. And then the next thing you need to do is just enable this one. But before that, let's take a look at security. I said show common name SVM 2+1. So you see the current one is still this one, right? So we need to enable the new one. We use command security SSL. Modify server enable true with the vServer name SVM 2+1 followed by CA SVM 2+1 and then with the server number which is the one we just created. So yes, and then we shoot again. You see the new one is up and running and the server is enabled. Then the next thing we need to do is to delete the old one because the old one is still there. You can see from here. This one is still there, right? Then now we just go ahead and delete that. So we're going to use command security certificate delete type server, vServer, SVM2 class 1, and common name, SVM2 class 1, then dash CA, SVM2 class 1, server number, which is the 16, right? 16809015067B4E18. Okay. Then so it's gone. We hope this video is helpful. Thanks for watching.